Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about bacterial artificial chromosome vector. Bacterial artificial chromosome vector is also called as BAC, is a DNA construct based on the functional fertility plasmid or F plasmid used for transforming and cloning in bacteria, usually E. coli. They are capable of carrying approximately up to 300 kb of insert DNA sequence. Now the common gene component of BAC, it consists of a RepE site for the plasmid replication and regulation of copy number, and PAR-A and PAR-B for partitioning F plasmid DNA into daughter cells during division and ensure stable maintenance of the BAC. Selectable markers for the antibiotic resistance. Some BAC also have LAG-Z at the cloning site for blue or white screening or white selection. Then there will be a T7 or SP6 site which is a phage promoter for transcription of inserted gene, and there will be a origin S or origin for replication site. Now the steps involved in molecular cloning of BAC vector. First, the cloning vector, that is the BAC vector as well as the foreign DNA, will be digested with the same restriction enzyme to get a sticky end in both the gene of our interest and the vector, and in the vector. Then these gene of our interest will be inserted into the vector with the help of an enzyme T4 ligase. After inserting the gene of our interest into the BAC vector, this vector are transformed into bacterial cell and it will be allowed to amplified so we can get a multiple copies of BAC vectors. I mean, even along with the vector, we will get the gene of our interest is also going to be multiplied. Later, the screening will be done by screening the white and blue colonies. Now, the blue colonies having a plasmid without insert, that is, it is a non-transformant, whereas the white colony have a plasmid with the foreign gene of our interest. So in this way, screening of the transformant will be done. Now the application of BAC. BACs are being greatly used in modeling genetic diseases in order to study their effect in the experimentation of transgenic mice. BAC have been used to study neurological diseases such as Alzheimer's disease or in the case of Down syndrome. The genome of several large DNA viruses and RNA viruses have been cloned as BACs. These constructs are referred to as infectious clones. Now the comparison between YAC and BAC system. Usually the features are listed here. In case of YAC, the configuration is linear in case of YAC, whereas circular in BAC. Host for the yeast artificial chromosome is yeast, whereas bacterial artificial chromosome vector is bacteria. Copy number is 1. In case of BAC, it is 1 to 2. Cloning capacity is unlimited in case of YAC, whereas none to very low in case of a BAC. Chimerism is seen up to 40%, whereas chimerism is nil in BAC. Insert stability is unstable in YAC, whereas it is very stable in a BAC. So that's why it is more suitable. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.